putting coal, though yesterday with Secretary Coal and Minister, I had to promise, sir, first thing we will have to go for import substitution. I will stop the import of 2 million tons of coal. My mine Talabira will come in 2 years. In that case, I will get the domestic coal. But till such time, can Coal India give me 2 million ton coal extra? Coal India chairman was there. He told, as per FSA, it can be 70%. 30% you will have to buy through auction. Well, I will not take this uncertainty because there NTPL will depend on the coal availability as such. I will have to stock coal in fact. And if you have to give me coal, then promise me, because you cannot give me the same calorie peak value coal that I get through import. And now the imported coal practically is cheaper with less ash content, with high calorie peak value. So if you are going to give me high calorie peak value coal from your specific mines, could be okay, but in that case, the landed cost of the fuel there should not be more than what we are paying for the imported coal. So that they have promised, they are reworking on it, because last time when I had the discussion with them, they suggested us something which was pushing our tariff by 40 paisa almost. So now, on 13th, maybe Mr. Pillai, you have to go there and go with a working sheet that whatever the landed cost of our fuel there, the imported coal, including the calorific value, whatever coal they will give us, either from Mahanadi coal fields or that ECL, what they were suggesting, that should not push up my cost. Because again, your tariff going up, possibly, the way Taka has been grounded, you will be grounded also tomorrow. You know, the company nearby Taka, hardly there is any uptake of power from them, because their cost of production, I mean cost of generation, is more than ours. So in Tamil Nadu preference, though PPA is there, they are on the low order. So we should not go into that trap. That's one. And then second, I thought, if there could be maybe with Jain Saab here or Srivastav Saab here, because I'm a non-technical man, I think I take the liberty of thinking wild sometimes, restricting myself to the conventional way of thinking. Could we, when my lignite is available here and the distance to Tuticorin is by train, it could be around 5 hours distance, could there be blending? And I know some coal was taken, blending has taken place, I would look for that if possible. Or could there be 2 stages of firing? Because I know coal gets fired at a high temperature, maybe 900 degrees centigrade plus, and here it is something around 840 degrees centigrade, something like that. So possibly by that degree, if the lignite is fired first, then it will turn into vapor sort of thing. Could be. So maybe those are the areas where we will have to. Can you find out the multi-use of lignite? We have Salem. Salem there, maybe the blast furnace. Can you utilize that? So all those things, specific concerns, and bringing down our maintenance time. I know it is happening. Earlier we used to work for 2 shifts, now we're working 3 shifts. So the availability. And when the unit goes down under a forced outage, that time take up certain jobs, which normally. So this overall routine can always be. Maybe there are cases where entire year no formal overhauling is done, but the plant health you have to keep in mind. So maybe all those new areas for energy saving, for energy both generation, going beyond the threshold, and coming to the trading where the technical minimum restricts you. Could there be another way of looking at it? Those are the few things we'll have to. And then keeping in view our expansion, that again at Barsingsar we are going for BC technology. So whatever the problems we faced here, maybe from the very beginning we have to take care that all those things are not repeated. Barsingsar, we faced it a lot, and there, here also, still it is not stabilized. So all those aspects we have to keep in mind. So these are the specific areas where the takeaway should be used. And of course, learning is unending. And the papers presented, I was told, I have got the feedback, have been excellent. And there must be good learning for everybody. But as the lady told first, the learning is not enough because we are not here the academicians, we are basically the practitioners. So one is the learning for academic purpose, another is the, so we are basically into the applied part of it. So with the application of that learning, if we can better the processes, if you can renew our capabilities, and if you can do the things in a better way so that our new projects coming at different places, we don't again suffer from time overrun or cost overrun. And of course, existing facilities will have to maintain and run well. With this, of course, I will not say a few words. I took a lot of time, I know. But yesterday, though, throughout the day, I was the minister and the team of secretaries, as one of my friends told that physically I was there, but mentally I was here. And when in the evening, Arnab Goswami was to be there for a frank and brutal interaction regarding the way the country is moving, the national economy is moving. So I just went to minister and told, sir, I'll have to be there tomorrow. So will you allow me? I'll skip the dinner. I'll skip Mr. Arnab Goswami's session. Then he told me, look, this is a good session. Well, I said, no, at least I can watch him on TV, but I will not get all the people over here and all the people those who have assembled here unless I at least join them for the valedictory session. And I drove down in the morning, now with you, and tomorrow again, I'll have to drive down to Chennai for the board meeting the next day. So, with these words, let me wish the best for this company with all the strength of yours, with all the strength coming from my NLC family, NLC fraternity, fraternity of engineers, power excellence. Thank you. Goodbye.